Rifton gave her the silent treatment for a while until he gave in to Maxie's temptations, if you know what we mean. Yes. Spoiler warning, this is a recap of Under the Oak Tree Book 1 and Side Story. Rifton first saw Maxie when they were both children. He was a poor peasant boy living with a neglectful mother and an exhausted stepfather. The only thing that made Rifton smile was Maxie as he watched her from afar, even though she was a nobleman's daughter. Rifton felt that she was as sad and lonely as he was. One day, Rifton came home to find that his mother had taken her own life. She was waiting for her lover, Rifton's biological father, to return from war. And when she heard news of his death, she chose death as well. Rifton carried the body of his mother to the forest in the middle of the night to hide the fact that she died by suicide. The terror of feeling his dead mother's cold flesh and hair against his back chilled Rifton's heart. The bitterness from her abandonment of him was so great that Rifton ran away from home. Rifton decided to become a mercenary. His skills and charisma made him a formidable warrior, and he was even recruited into the Royal Order of the Remdragon Knights.
Nice.
But Riften's trauma had a lasting grip on him. He lived like a man who wanted to die, as Ruth once pointed out. He had no desire for women, wealth, or reputation. He just killed enemies, led knights, and earned a lot of money in the process. But that was all thanks to Ruth. The only thing Rifton cherished was the memory of Maxie. He tried to forget her because he knew she was out of his league, and every time he failed. Years later, Rifton saw Maxie again. Maxie didn't remember him, but Rifton felt like his heart began to beat again. Through a course of fateful events, which are absolutely shocking tear-jerker moments, so we advise you to read it yourself, the Duke married Maxie off to Rifton and sent Rifton on a dangerous dragon campaign. Contrary to the Duke's expectations, Rifton slayed the dragon and became the kingdom's hero. Rifton took Maxie to his land of Anatol, but he believed Maxie didn't like him, since she was forced into marriage and he was a lowborn. Quickly, though, Rifton felt Maxie opening up, and their intimacy grew. She was everything he wanted, and she didn't seem too unhappy at being with him. Rifton wanted to do anything to fill her life with luxury and comfort so she could live as the noble lady she was raised to be. But she wanted to learn magic, because of her desire to help Rifton, which created periodic rifts between the two. Then one day, Maxie secretly followed Rifton to battle in a faraway land. When Rifton found out, he was completely shocked and tried to convince her to return to safety, but to no avail. Pissed off and worried, Rifton gave her the silent treatment for a while until he gave in to Maxie's temptations, if you know what we mean. But while Rifton was away, monsters attacked the castle where Maxie was. Maxie used magic to single-handedly save the castle and everyone inside. But it nearly killed her, and it caused her to have a miscarriage, though neither Rifton or Maxie knew that she was pregnant. Rifton lost his mind in sorrow. He blamed himself for impregnating her and not protecting her. He swiftly sent Maxie to be healed in the capital. After finalizing the victory, Rifton went to the capital only to find out Maxie wasn't there. She'd gone back to her father at Croiso Castle. Rifton thought Maxie didn't want to be with him, but he wanted to see her one last time. However, when Rifton arrived at Croiso Castle, what he saw made him lose his mind. This part of the story is so good that you have to read it yourself, but here are some hints of what happened to tempt you. Rifton and Maxie returned to Anatol together, but Duke Croiso devised a plan to destroy Rifton, and the only way to foil that plan was for Maxie to go away to the Mage Tower, which meant she'd be away for 3 years. Heartbroken, Rifton declared that he wouldn't wait for Maxie if she went. Though this broke her heart too, Maxie went anyway. Just as her ship sailed off over the horizon, Rifton arrived at the pier. For the first time since his mother's death, Rifton wept as he confessed to himself that what he said was a lie. So, there we have it, the end of book one and the side story where we learned Rifton's POV. Now you're all caught up and ready to dive into book two when it comes out on Amazon on April 5th. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel for more great UOT content.